Welcome back to part 2, and we're going to start animating the giant robotic doll. First off, we'll keyframe these layers X position. As you can see, in our design, we have two back hair layers. And we masked one layer to the other. This masked back hair layer will be used to replace the doll's face when it's turning around like this. Let's turn on the half layer. We'll use this half layer as a reference to manipulate the doll's face shapes, to create a side view as she's turning from the center to the right. Let's start with moving the playhead to the center of your timeline. Then move the face layers one by one to the right side by changing their X position. By designing the side view in advance and using it as a reference, it's easier for us to manipulate shapes to create the head turn. Face lines are these two lines near the doll's ears. To animate these lines, we'll keyframe their trim path start, to make them disappear as the doll turns her head around. For the right ear, apart from keyframing its X position, we also need to keyframe its scale and rotation to flip it. Open the right ear's contents. And keyframe the opacity from Group 1's transform. By making the opacity quickly go from 100 to 0, we'll be able to make this part of the ear disappear. And we'll have the back side of the ear. When the doll's face is on the right hair bun will move to the left like this. After adding main keyframes to create key poses, we'll continue with adding more details to the doll's face to smooth out the animation. Let's start with the face layer. Open the face contents and keyframe the path. Open the half layer and copy this path keyframe from group 8. Then paste it to this face path keyframe. And we'll have a side view face shape like this. To transition face shapes, we'll add in between keyframes and adjust the face shapes. The nose will also become smaller when they're turning to the side. The front hair will move to the right side, followed by the back hair. When the doll fully turns her head around, we'll only see her back hair, the back side of the ears, and hair buns. The left ear needs to be under the hair. This can be easily done by duplicating the left ear layer. Place one of the left ear layer under the hair layer. Change its X scale to -100 to flip it horizontally. Then, at this frame, we'll keyframe both of the left ear layers' scale and trim them to create the flip transition. Keyframe the front hair and back hair's path to change the hair shapes as the doll turns around. Keyframe the nose's X position to move it to the right like this. The eyebrows will also move to the right. The nose and eyebrows are masked, so when you drag them out to the right, they will be invisible, which is what we want to happen when the doll turns her head around. Split the nose layer. And place the nose 2 layer under the face layer. Copy its first keyframe to its last keyframe. Do the same to the hairpin and cheek layer. The hair buns will swap their position when the head is turning around. We'll keyframe their position and rotation to achieve this motion. After having the hair buns motion, we'll split the hair bun layers and place these layers right under the back hair layer. Then readjust the bun's position. After creating the 180-degree head turn, we'll make three copies of the doll rotating composition. We'll use one for the front, one for the back, and one for backup in case we make any mistake. We still have the original composition to go back to. Open the back composition. Delete all of the front layers. And also delete all layers' keyframes except for their last one. Drag and drop the doll back composition to our timeline. For the front composition, we'll delete all of the back layers, and all layers' keyframes. And we'll have a still front view and back view of the character. Drag and drop the doll front composition to the timeline. Then, add time remap to the doll rotating composition. But before adding time remap, let's open the doll rotation composition and check its duration. The 180 head turn lasts for 60 frames, so we'll set its duration to 60 frames. After setting the doll rotation composition's duration, we'll add time remap. By using time remap, we can easily control the head turn speed. The back composition will start where the doll turns around. Duplicate the doll rotating. And reverse these keyframes to make her head rotate 180 degrees again. We'll make the second head turn speed faster than the first ones. And the front composition will start where the doll faces us again. After creating the head turns to make the doll turn her back and spin around to face the players, we'll continue with animating her eyes. To animate the eyes, first, duplicate group 3 of each eye. Then nest groups 2 and 4 into one group and merge them. change the fill color. Select Intersect Mode for merge paths. And the pupil will be masked like this. Do the same to the other eye. Adjust the pupil's anchor point. In the series, the doll will scan her eyes over the players quickly. We'll keyframe the pupil's position to create this motion. As we extended the duration of our project, we'll need to adjust the red guard's loop within this duration as well. Preview the entire animation, and add more details if needed. Let's add more keyframes to make the eyes move continuously. And we have finished animating this scene from the Squid Game series. We hope you have had a lot of fun animating with us. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials. See you in the next video.